Hello and welcome to the KBSCH YouTube channel, Peter Gull speaking. It's finally the time when I show you my whole medieval kit wearing it, and I do this piece by piece. Here we have the first piece, which is what I start with. It's the trousers. Nothing special to say, except maybe that trousers were not actually that common in medieval clothing. Many did with a longer tunic or something during the centuries, but those are made based on a Viking era trousers, so early medieval. So at least Norse people actually kind of like trousers, and I guess it's kind of obvious why they did. So here we have those trousers. I don't have a strictly medieval belt, but I guess we can expect them to look similar to what we have today. Maybe not as elaborate as this one, but that depended on the money, as usual. Now the t-shirt is not really on period. At the other hand, simple shirts did exist for quite a long time. Let's get to the next piece. This is kind of what probably everybody wore those days, a tunic. It was already common in Roman times, tunica. So it's pretty much a normal thing. So, here we go. This is a bit of a bigger tunic than I would need it. At the other hand, tunics are quite forgiving if it comes to size. They more or less fit all the time. Now, next piece. This is the first piece of armor, and it's legitimately an armor. This I bought as a Viking style armor, Viking style gambeson. So it's at least roughly to what the Viking would have worn, may have worn, or some early medieval person. It's kind of the cheapest kind of armor you could get, and it was widely used, as far as I know, during the whole Middle Ages. Because it always did its job, it does a pretty good job. It's a thick fabric, several layers, and it's easy to put on. And hard to cut through. Oops, this one is not as big as the tunic. And I got in. Of course, now I'm already prepared for a Norse winter, except for socks. And since we have a Middle European summer here, I'm not freezing to death, let's put it this way. This is still bigger than my size. At least my belly size. But I could do an additional hole or two. Here we go. So, and now to the piece of armor, as what you would probably call armor. The chainmail. This one is not historically accurate because they did not have galvanized iron there, but it's more practical. It's a nice 10 kilograms of iron. Oops. I'm getting into kind of a conflict with my lamp. Oops, now that's getting interesting. Here we go. I never have been so heavy armored before, actually. Now I need to get some other belt for the chainmail, because actually they always use a belt to put some weight from the chainmail to your hips, not so much to your back. And now, of course, you don't want to fight on the Nordic battlefield bare feet, at least if you can avoid it. So we have a pair of shoes, my latest addition. Oh, now I definitely have a conflict with my lamp. So, here we have those. I can't say if exactly this type of shoes was used to fight on Nordic battlefields. I have no idea. But they are a type which probably was used for a pretty long time. And it could have been made by any Viking with a knife and some wood in his hands, and some leather or whatever to strap it on the feet. I expect them to have worn some kind of socks. They could have made them, that's not really a technical problem. But I did not do any research on medieval socks, actually. But that's kind of my full set. Of course, for a real battle, a helmet and a shield and a spear would be greatly advised to have. At least a spear. and a helmet, actually. Both. But at the other end, I'm not portraying a really rich man here. But with the male, I guess I would have been one which was well off. Now I have to get used to moving around like this. It's not as stiff as it may look. There is a bit much material under the shoulders here. But otherwise, it's quite okay. And the rest is just building up muscles, and if you wear it all day, that should come with normal use. So, that's about it. Now I'm off to cut the video. Have a nice day and see you later. And thank you for watching Javi's TH videos. Bye!